So in today's one, I'm going to show you how to blur your background in DaVinci Resolve, like this. If you didn't notice any difference, just rewatch this section. So I'm going to show you two ways of doing it, and one will mimic real lens, basically when you open up that aperture all the way to f1.2 and there is creamy background going on with that bokeh and all the stuff. So let's jump into DaVinci Resolve and let's get started.
So we're inside DaVinci Resolve and let's assume that I finished grading my video and it's time to blur the background. So for that, go to the color tab and in here you can see my node tree. What I want to do is add another node to the end of my node tree and let's rename this and call this blur to stay organized. What I want to do next is go to the magic mask and I want to select myself. So for that, just place a couple dots on me. Something like so. And if you're on DaVinci Resolve 19, it will be a stroke for you. Basically, it's the same. Now, if I want to see what I selected, just I'm going to click on this toggle right here. So you can see it is a pretty good selection there. And in order to get the better quality for the selection, obviously you can switch to the better. It will give you better results, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm not going to do that. Now I need to track myself. I'm going to click track backwards and forwards. And let's just wait till AI mask analyze everything and track myself. Okay, now when it's finished, what I need to do now is I need to invert the mask. So I will select everything but me. And now I need to go to this blur here, and if I'm going to increase the radius right here, you can see everything is blurred out, and if I'm going to decrease it, everything will be sharp. So you don't want to go like crazy high because like it will look unnatural, but you can go to something like this and it will look pretty organic. But there is a better way, so let's switch to the second way of doing this, which will mimic the real camera. So for the second method, the first steps are the same. Basically, you need to add node to the end of the node tree and you need to track yourself. But here's the difference. You don't need to invert this selection right here. Instead, you need to go to the effects and you need to search for the defocus background. And let's add this to the end of our node tree. And boom, you can see it is already defocused. And let's just do something like this to see it better. And let's just zoom in on this area right here. And let's increase the blur. And you can see it is mimicking the real camera. So there is a few parameters right here. There is this blur, which you saw. Blur more, blur less. There is saturation, so you can desaturate the background if you want to. And there's this colorize, so you can choose any color that you want and you can increase. So I don't know, if you want to go with some crazy teal and orange, you can go something like this just to stylize your video. And there is advanced options. So there's blur type. Obviously we want to go with lens to mimic the real lens. And there is the anamorphism parameter, so if you want to mimic the anamorphic lens. So again, let's zoom in on the icons and you can see the difference. So can you see it, right? So that's that. And there is the highlights, which will mimic the highlights with the anamorphic lens. So and there is just the global blend, so overall strength of this defocus. And basically this is two ways how to blur your background in DaVinci Resolve. And if you want to know how to make any voice sound like a phone call in DaVinci Resolve, you should watch this tutorial next.